everyone. So today I'm going to be showing you how to recreate this pretty girly curly hairstyle. Now I do this quite often. Every time I do it, I always get a lot of people asking how I did it. So I thought I would make a video, and because it's obviously something that people want to try, and this way they can recreate it. Now this is kind of like a fake a bob hairstyle. And I know that if any of you watch Bubs Beauty, she's done one of those recently too. I've not had a chance to watch this video yet, but I've been doing this for years, so it's probably a pretty similar technique. And I used to have a bob, and sometimes, you know, you just miss it, but you don't want to cut all your hair off. So this is really perfect. This is also a great hairstyle if you're trying to grow out a bob. For year 11 prom a couple of years ago, I had like this length hair, and I couldn't really do a lot with it. So I made up this hairstyle to do for my prom. So this is what my hair was like for my prom. And it looks really sophisticated. I especially like this when I'm wearing like a blazer, some skinny jeans and some heels. And I think it just looks really good. Also, I'm so sorry that I did not upload a video last week. It was my 18th birthday and I had loads of exams. And then I got a cold, which meant I had no voice. So that there is no point in me even trying to film a video. So I'm really, really sorry about that. I will try not to let it happen again. But hopefully this video will be good enough to make up for the lost week. So I hope you enjoy it. So I'm just gonna start by putting some heat protection on my head, because obviously you're gonna be applying heat to it. So I am going to be using the VO5 Smoothly Does It Heat Protect Serum. I'm just putting about one pulp, maybe two, a little bit on the palm of my hand. Smooth it through the ends, especially on the ombre bit, because that obviously needs all the protection it can get because it's been bleached. Now I will be using the Babyliss Curling Wand. You can get these for relatively cheap from Boots or Superdrug or other places that retail stuff like this. And it's kind of like a barrel but without the clamp. And I prefer using these for the ones with the clamp, just because I find them a bit more difficult. And I'll be using this on full heat because I have quite thick hair. So while I'm waiting for that to heat up, I am going to section off my hair. So only really the bottom bit is left. Now I'll be using these clips, these types of clips, to fasten my hair up. It doesn't really matter what type of clips you use here. As long as your hair stays up, then, as long as your hair stays up, that's all that really matters. So now that it's warm, the little light has stopped flashing, I'm just gonna take about 1 to 2 inches of hair, and having the barrel pointing vertically down, wrap the hair around it and hold for about 10 seconds. And you let go, you'll keep holding onto the bottom and just pull that out and release. Now, it doesn't matter if they're not the tightest of curls. It's just, it can be as messy or as tight or as wavy or whatever as you want it to be. I'm just going for kind of loose, yet still kind of defined, somewhere in the middle curls. And I'm just going to do this for all of my head. Okay, so I've just done the bottom two layers of my hair. And what I find is really important to do is to spray in between each layer just so the bottom one doesn't fall flat. So I'm just going to spray this one, and this is just using my Silver Crin by Weller hairspray that I used in, well, that I showed you in my empties one video that I've done. So as you can see, these are looking quite nice and curly. So now I just need to curl the top layer of my hair. So again, getting about 1 inch long pieces and getting really tight to the root on the top layer, because that bit's important or else it's going to look quite flat. I don't know if I mentioned this before, you should always curl away from your face. Like, so on this side I'm doing now, I'll be curling that way, but on the other side I'll be curling that way, and then that way it just kind of really opens up your face and makes them look really natural. Another way, if you find like you're counting to 10 with your curls and it's not really working, you can just really, really carefully tap the hair, and if the hair feels warm, then it's more than likely ready. Look at that. Beautiful curl. So the bottom two layers of my hair took roughly about 7 or 8 minutes. So it doesn't actually take that long. I do this before school without problem, but I do get up at 6:30 every day, just as a general rule. What I really love about this hairstyle is when it's finished, it lasts all day. I have gone to the gym with this hairstyle and walked out looking the exact same as when I walked in. It's a really durable hairstyle, and that's why I love it so much. Now obviously you're using a curling iron, and I hate to be really patronising to you all, but if you're quite inexperienced with a curling wand, please use the glove that comes with it for this hand right here, because you will burn yourself so much. I didn't do that when I bought my curling wand. I've had this for about 2 years now, and I had so many burns all over my hands. So I would definitely recommend that until you are completely used to curling your hair with it, use the glove. It's like a heat-proof glove, it's not just like a random woolly glove, but do use it because it will save your hands quite a bit. Okay, so I'm just going to kind of, what's it called? Seal it? Sealing it, or is it? Well, whatever I'm doing with my hairspray, it's important to make sure I put the hairspray on. Also, remember to turn off your curling iron, because if you have a dad like mine, he will get yelled at if he finds it left on. And you could, of course, set fire to your house, and that would be bad. So turn your curling iron off. Right, so sometimes I just go to school with it like this and then do the next step afterwards, because these curls will last all day and it looks quite nice and girly and quite funky just like this. But most of the time, I just go straight to the next step and just let that last all day. So, now I don't really know how to describe this bit, but I kind of take up the top layers and I judge how long I want the kind of the style to be. So sometimes you have to hold the long layers back and just kind of play around with it. So I decided that I am indeed quite happy with it like that. Should have been wearing probably a lighter colour for this. Let's see if you can see it. So just kind of collarbone length. So with this bit, I'm now going to turn around and using a bobby pin. I don't know if you can see that. There you go. Bob standard bobby pin. I'm going to twist this piece of hair around, so it's nice and tight. Just keep twisting. Twist it in to the bottom of your head and secure with the bobby pin. Now this might take about 2 bobby pins per side, especially if you have quite thick hair like me. Or what you can do is, instead of doing one side in one big thing, can take it in lots of different sections. So that's this side of my hair kind of done. Just gonna do the exact same with this side. Try and make it look relatively equal. I did it for school the other day and it looked so lopsided all day. All I could think about was the fact that my hair was not equal on both sides of my face. That's just me being a little bit OCD, I guess. Right, and I like to get like a nice grip. I use this pearl one because I kind of have a bit of an obsession with pearls. So I'm going to have this pearl one, and then just secure it. And this is quite a heavy grip, like it's made out of proper metal, not whatever crap Primark makes, the ones I was using a minute ago out of. So this holds a lot of hair. And so, just in the middle of everything, you just grip it in. And that should hold that quite nicely. And now, I always feel like it's quite nice if you can give the top a bit of volume. So either you can back comb using a comb, or you can do what I do, and that is spray some hairspray on the roots and just itch, as if kind of like you're a monkey itching your head, but really work that hairspray into the roots like this, and then just fluff it out through the rest. You can do it the other side of your parting as well. And so sometimes, if I'm in the mood, I like to put different headbands or hair bows in. And I think sometimes this can just make it look a little more dressy if you're going out in the evening, or a bit more girly or anything. So there we have it. So if you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up and comment what you thought in the comments below. Also, please subscribe and feel free to make any suggestions to videos you want me to see in the future. Next week's video is going to be a little late because I'm in London next weekend. So I'm going to be doing kind of like a vlog of my time in London, and then also at the end of that video is going to be a quick haul of all the stuff I buy there. So that will probably be coming to you on Monday or Tuesday. And I will also be doing a Valentine's Day makeup tutorial that week as well, just as a bit of an extra video in there. So I really do hope you like this, and I hope to see you all soon. Bye! Okay, so I've just applied how much I want.